discussion. I did my whole teaching practice on whole class discussions. First thing about that is the problem, you have to find the best teaching practice. Well, one teaching practice that is good, not the best one, I mean, which is whole class discussions. What that is, it is when students are able to talk about a particular topic without a general right or wrong answer. So basically, students can raise their hand, like in an English class, for example, and they can just lead a discussion. The subject area that classroom discussions work best is English and foreign language, because you can state your opinion about a book such as Hamlet, like you can say how Ophelia died, which is one of the characters in Hamlet, or why something happened. Or also it teaches students to speak in language that are foreign, such as you can have conversations in Spanish and it goes easier for the teacher. One good thing about whole class discussions is the entire classroom learns. Basically what that is students can assist each other in written and spoken work, and they can use their opinions and they can back it up with evidence. Basically what that is, just backing up your statements with evidence. Another purpose of classroom discussions are students can participate at any time. If the student is uncomfortable in the classroom, they can wait until they understand the gist of the question and then raise their hand to answer the question, and then they'll feel more comfortable just asking questions to the teacher in general. The last purpose of classroom discussions are the role of the student changes. What that means is student dynamics can change. Basically, the students can explain and justify situations in open discussion, state why they believe their opinion is why it is, and they can propose different answers. And how teachers can determine if discussion is going bad is how the entire class reacts. If the classroom is tired, then the teacher can engage students by throwing a ball, for example, to elementary school students, and like passing it around to each student to get them engaged. Or another reason why the entire class might not react is because they don't know the answer. And for that, the teacher could explain the students on the right path of what the answer is and get them to participate. Or the last reason why a discussion might not be going good is because the students just don't care about the topic and they need to be engaged. One way to help the students with that is also passing the ball around and getting students to engage. That would be a helpful technique. And I have my work cited right here, pumpkins, because it's Halloween coming up and I need pumpkins.